I've seen every argument out there about why AI bad, but I think the most annoying and most wrong one is how it's going to destroy the environment because of how much water it uses. And look, there are fair arguments about the ever-increasing electricity demand from AI and data centers, but for some reason, I've seen a ton of articles and people really focusing on the whole water consumption aspect of it, with titles of articles like, AI is accelerating the loss of our scarcest natural resource, and a bottle of water per email, the hidden environmental costs of using AI chatbots. All of them talking about just how much water data centers, quote, use and consume to cool the computers. But when you hear what's actually happening, I think you'll agree with me that it's really not a problem at all. Or at the very least, not nearly as big as a problem they make it out to be. A quick explanation for how data centers cool the computers. For one part, you have a closed loop of water that pulls heat away from the computers, and this water stays the same, none is added or removed. It's pumped in a circle, basically, where it gets heated up by the chips, and then continues on through the radiators, which cool it, and then gets pumped back to recool the chips again and repeat. At the same time, different water is pumped in from outside the data center and is sprayed onto the radiators. As that water heats up, it does more than simply absorb the heat off of the radiators, but some of it also evaporates. And that phase change pulls even more heat from the cooling loop. And the water that is being consumed, that all these articles are making a huge deal about, is just the water that is being evaporated back into the air as regular clean water vapor. Now, I should elaborate on two terms that you need to be familiar with because they are used all over the place in these articles, and I've actually already said them. They are usage and consumption. And these terms actually have specific technical meanings, which I would argue are being abused by a lot of these articles. This article actually does a good job of explaining the difference. It says, water use describes the total amount of water withdrawn from its source to be used. Measures of water usage help evaluate the level of demand from industrial, agricultural, and domestic users. For example, a manufacturing plant might require 10,000 gallons of fresh water a day for cooling, running, or cleaning the equipment. Even if the plant returns 95% of the water to the watershed, the plant needs all 10,000 gallons to operate. Water consumption is the portion of water use that is not returned to the original water source after being withdrawn. Consumption occurs when water is lost into the atmosphere through evaporation or incorporated into a product or plant, such as a corn stalk, and is no longer available for reuse. So first of all, if an article complains about water usage by AI, not even consumption, I would say it's not even worth reading. Because the usage includes the water that gets returned back into the original source. So that would be like opening up your toolbox, taking out a screwdriver, using it, and then putting it back, and then saying that you somehow used up the screwdriver and you can't use it again. And then if you take out the screwdriver again to use it a second time, you somehow used up two screwdrivers. It's the stupidest argument ever. Now, consumption, at least there's like some logic there, but again, for just complaining about water usage, it's nonsense. Before I continue my rant, something else that's unfortunately being used is all your personal data being sold by data brokers, which is where today's sponsor comes in, DeleteMe, a privacy service to which I myself have been a paying customer for over 4 years now before they ever even sponsored. If you've ever Googled yourself, you definitely have seen the countless data broker websites who not only collect and display all your personal information, like name, address, and phone number, but then also sell it to companies and other sketchy people to do whatever they want with it. This also makes it easier for malicious people to find and use your own info against you in phishing attacks, identity theft, harassment, and more. But that's where DeleteMe comes in. They do all the work for you in submitting removal requests on your behalf. At the moment, they automatically scan 133 data brokers and are constantly adding new ones that pop up. And when you sign up, you get a privacy report showing exactly which sites you were removed from after 7 days and every 3 months after that. You can even submit custom requests to remove your data from hundreds of other sites, and an expert will handle it for you. This includes some surprising sites like berkeley.edu and certain government sites, so not just purely data brokers. Plus, they have other useful privacy tools like email masking and phone number masking for US users. So if you want to get your personal information removed from the web and search results, go to joindeleteme.com/Theojo and use the promo code Theojo for 20% off all US consumer plans. And with all that being said, let's continue. Most articles I've seen at least do have the decency of talking about consumption, though I still think it's just a nothing burger. Some, but not all articles, seem to talk about humans consuming water and then go on to talk about data centers consuming water, but not in the same way. It really is misleading to use that same term, because when we talk about a person consuming water, usually they're imagining drinking the water or using it in a way where it ends up down a drain where it needs to be treated and processed, or in the worst case, it ends up just getting dumped into a river to basically pollute it. But in the context of AI consumes water, like I already said, it's not the same thing. In most cases, it just gets evaporated back into the atmosphere, or sometimes cooling can actually be done by taking some water and diverting it off a river and then through the radiators and then just put back into the river slightly warmer. Though I guess technically that would not even be consuming it because it's going back into the river. So yes, AI data centers consume water by turning it into clean water vapor that just goes and gets rained down again. But is anyone really losing sleep over that? It's not the type of water consumption that gets put into a product that truly can't be used again. As for articles that do talk about water usage, you might be wondering if there's even that big of a difference between the water usage and consumption. Well, here's one study that I've seen cited in articles that estimated that by 2027, the total global annual water withdrawal, which is the same thing as usage, used by data centers and AI could be 4.2 to 6.6 billion cubic meters. Okay, that sounds like a lot. But of that, the actual consumption is only around one-tenth of that, 0.38 to 0.6 billion cubic meters, or around 100 to 160 billion gallons. So in my opinion, anyone who's only talking about AI water usage is making it sound 10 times worse than it actually is. Now, half a billion cubic meters of water sounds like a lot, but how bad actually is that? Well, for some perspective, let's compare it to something else, like the total global annual amount of water that is truly wasted from leaking pipes, which according to a recent study is 126 billion cubic meters. And remember, they're projecting not even now, but 2 years from now, the global AI usage is going to be 4.2 to 6.6. I think we've got bigger fish to fry. I mean, even just in the US and Canada alone, it's 14.8 billion cubic meters wasted from leaking pipes. But it's actually probably even worse, because I'll add that the study only looked at so-called non-revenue water, meaning water that utility companies produced and know they produced because they know how much they did, but was lost before it reached any customers because it was either stolen or more likely leaking from the infrastructure. Meaning that that does not even include the amount of water lost to leaks within someone's house or yard, or running the faucet too long and just regularly wasting water, and all that. Also, let's take a look at the water consumption by something else, like how much it takes to make our food. This figure was in gallons, so let's remember that the total 2027 global annual AI consumption is estimated to be up to 160 billion gallons. And compare that to a measure from 2014 to 2016, so probably even more now, from the consumption of just the beef cattle industry in the USA, which consumed 34,645 billion gallons a year. That's around 130 billion cubic meters, or roughly around the same amount that is lost to leaking pipes annually, interestingly enough. So if we haven't been freaking out about the amount of water literally wasted from leaking pipes, or how much water is being used for agriculture, and that, again, was just one industry, then I'm not going to freak out over the water used by AI. And even if you are, well, there's good news, because future data centers probably won't even have this problem anyway. Microsoft, for example, already announced that all of their new data centers beginning construction since August 2024, so already being built, will use a fully closed loop, zero evaporation design. And Google has said that by 2030, they aim to replenish 120% of the fresh water that they consume overall. So yes, that means actually returning more fresh water than they take in. For example, by using non-potable water for cooling and then treating any water that doesn't evaporate before returning it to the watershed. And apparently 25% of their data centers do this already. So I am definitely not going to lose any sleep over AI water consumption. I would be curious to know what you guys think though. Were you maybe concerned about AI and the water usage from any articles you've seen or tweets and stuff? And maybe now you have a little bit more of a better understanding of it. And it's possible you still could be worried about it. That's fine. I'd love to talk about it down in the comments. But hopefully for most people, it eased some unnecessary fears that have been spread. So yeah, let me know what you think. And if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up. Thanks again to DeleteMe for sponsoring. And again, if you want to have your personal information removed from data brokers, go to joindeleteme.com/TheoJoe and use the promo code TheoJoe for a discount. If you want to keep watching, next up, I'd recommend a video that I made about a program I wrote for generating Windows error message boxes for memes and stuff that has been pretty popular. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.